This is a Sweet Speaks.
Recently, I went to London and I met with my friend, Charles Keatington, with whom I live streamed last Saturday. And I also met with a viewer known as Assyrian King. Both Charles Keatington and Assyrian King guided me around Chelsea and London. So, let's have a look.
So now, it's early in the morning and I'm waiting for the bus to take me to Oslo Airport. So I have arrived to Oslo Airport and well, let's find my flight. So I'm in Chelsea, London. And these streets in this part of London, they just look wonderful. And by the way, where's the rain? It hasn't rained on me yet and I've been here since yesterday. This is the other side of the street, Fean Street. And I think I'll go to the Fean and see if they have any food. I think I'll try that. Alright, so now I'm at the Fean in Chelsea, London, and it's time to have a burger. So, Charles Keatington, yes. where are we now?
At a pub called the Fean, I think.
Yes, I just had a meal here, and that was wonderful, but that was before you arrived.
A Fean burger?
Something like that, with cheese and bacon.
Ooh, nice.
Yes.
That is haram, I think.
Why do you think I ordered bacon?
Yeah.
So we are still have a few more days in London.
Yes, and tomorrow I will take you to Margaret Thatcher's grave.
Yes.
It's just a few blocks from here.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah. So we'll get. So I'll get to document that too.
Yes.
So we're looking forward to that.
Yes.
I like this this style of architecture.
Yes, it's very beautiful. Picturesque.
Yes, it's not these modernist places that you see in Scandinavia.
No.
Although I think they might have that in England too somewhere, but not right here at least.
No. It's a little more old-fashioned.
Yes, that's wonderful.
Yes.
So we're standing by the River Thames.
Yes, the famous River Thames.
And what's the name of this bridge?
Albert Bridge.
Albert Bridge.
Yes.
And our favorite British Prime Minister,
yes.
Well, one of the two, she said something about the River Thames, I think.
Yes, she said, if my critics saw me walking over the Thames, they would say it was because I couldn't swim.
Yes, and that was the Baroness Margaret Thatcher.
Yes, she wasn't Baroness by then.
No, no, not then.
No.
The Baroness to be.
Yes, and she is, by the way, we're just a few yards from here.
Oh, we'll go, we'll have to go there later.
Yes.
So we are slowly walking through Chelsea looking for Margaret Thatcher's grave.
Yes.
And apparently spring has arrived.
Yes, and England is as pretty as a picture.
Yes, at least Chelsea is.
Yes.
So we have the street here. Yes. And on the other side of the street, the street, we have a tennis court. So Mr. Keatington, where are we now?
We are at the Royal Hospital Chelsea and we're standing just in front of Margaret Thatcher Infirmary where Sir Dennis Thatcher and Margaret Thatcher are buried.
Right. And as we can see, people are still leaving roses here.
Yes, we will not forget her.
No.
Neither will we forget Dennis.
Let's see if we can get a picture of the... Here's the infirmary. And here are the graves.
Yes.
So, this is the woman who saved Britain from socialism.
Yes, and she and President Reagan saved the world from communism.
Yes.
That was a wonderful thing.
Yes. The Soviet Union collapsed, the Eastern Bloc.
Yes. Yes, those were the days.
Yes.
So
you know, the first thing Margaret Thatcher said to Gorbachev when they met for the first time.
What was
that? I hate communism.
And what did he respond to that?
Well, he didn't dislike her.
Hmm, that's interesting.
They got along very well, actually.
Yes, but I think she said that this is a man we can work with.
Yes, I can do business with her, I think she said.
Yes.
And that is what she did.
And I think, wasn't it Pravda, the Soviet official newspaper, who named her the Iron Lady?
Yes.
And she then used the name with great pride?
Yes, she did. She was quite proud of it.
Yeah. Well, King, what can you tell us about this building?
This building is one of the oldest type in London. We've got Georgians, Edwardians and Victorians. The next one is the Victorian one with the long windows. This one is a Georgian.
Right.
One of the oldest type, goes back to sort of early 18th centuries. Beautiful. Every brick, as you can see, has been sort of designed especially for this building to actually match the patterns they got on the thing.
Right, that's great. Yes, thank you very much. So we're looking at the National History Museum.
Yeah.
In the area of Kensington, I think. Yes, that's where we are right now. This is the entrance to the National History Museum. It's a very large building. And looking at the people standing in line, it seems to be popular too. Let's see, there are the ceilings. So King, what does this represent?
This is one of the oldest signs. It goes back to 1911, if you look.
It's oh, yes.
Top. You say yes. 1911. There was signs saying to London, although we are in the central of London, but yes. London was a square mile. And still, we call it as a city yes. of London.
Yes, the city of London is a small area.
Yeah, which is a financial district now.
Yes.
So, as you can see, it says to Hounslow, 9 miles, and London, Hyde Park Corner, 1.
Yes. Yeah, that's great.
So, yeah.
We are in Kensington Gardens, and we are looking at the Albert Memorial. Of course, named after Prince Albert, the husband of Queen Victoria. And there are a lot of things to look at in both Chelsea and Kensington. So it's actually impossible to go through all London because it's just too much. I should have stayed here for a month, I think. What were you telling me about the corners?
Right. This is the Albert Memorial.
Yes.
That was built on the memory of Prince Albert.
Yes, the husband of Queen Victoria.
Queen Victoria, facing Albert Hall.
Yes.
Another sort of place left after them, built by them.
Yes.
And every corner of here, as you can see, there's a statue presenting a colony of Britain.
Right.
When you go further down, you can see it says India, I don't know, Asia, and sort of every corner has been built for that. That is India, I believe. This is India.
The one right
here? Right here, yeah.
In front of us?
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's see. So, oh, yes.
And
right.
Obviously, all around there is all sort of history you can say about it. All the detail of it.
Yes.
He wanted to do it because he wanted to be also a motorcycle.
So like I just said,
yeah, and it took years, I think possibly more than 5 years during the early 90s to bring this to his glory.
Right.
And I hope that cross going to stay there.
Yeah, the cross on the top here.
Yeah.
Yes, we certainly hope that.
Yeah.
So, like I said a few minutes ago, if I would like to see all of London, I would have to stay maybe a month.
No, well, it still wouldn't be enough anyway.
Yes.
So here's a statue of Prince Albert.
Yep.
And they weren't married for very many years because he died young.
That's right.
But Queen Victoria never remarried.
No, but she had lovers.
Yeah, so they say at least.
Yeah, and one of them was a Muslim, believe it or not. They made a film about him.
Oh, really?
Well. It's called Abdul.
Interesting.
And Brits with their pride and proud, they put it on the screen. And I was just thinking, what a lovely time to put such a film on the screen.
Oh, wow.
So we give more credit to the Muslim, like you say. Oh, yeah, you see, we got a share of your history. Yeah.
Oh, wow, that's amazing. So here we have Queen Victoria.
Yeah, we got a Queen Victoria in front of one of the palaces. She's called Kensington Palace.
Yeah, she was the head of...
This is a place for some residents, Prince's residence.
Right.
Prince Diana was here.
Yes.
And Duke of Kent lives here.
Oh.
Prince Harry and William were just here.
Right.
I think Prince William now, he got his own residence. So
yes, yes, probably. Yes.
But yeah, this is a few...
Yes,
second grade.
And this is in Hyde Park in London.
Yeah.
In front of Kensington Palace, we have William III, or at least his statue. And here is a view of this section of Hyde Park. Hyde Park is very large.
Well, it is very large.
It's very large. I think
it's the largest park in the world.
Yes, I think you could walk around here for days.
Yeah.
So I hope we don't get lost.
No.
Well, if you see this video,
every inch of it.
If you see this video, it means that we found our way out.
I know. I'm not being sure. Not in a safe hand. Don't worry. No panic.
Of course. It was a joke.
So this is what the British pub meal looks like.
Yes. It's a pig's ear platter. We are at the pig's ear.
Yes.
In Chelsea.
Yes. So we will. We need to cure our starvation here.
Yes. And I think this will do.
Yes, I think so.
Yes.
So it's Sunday afternoon, and there is the English flag. Not really sure what this building is. It might be Carlisle House. We'll check that. So the building with the English flag was not Carlisle House, but it's Chelsea Old Church. So we could have gone here today, but we were not aware of the existence of this place. Maybe next time in Chelsea. So I'm standing by Chelsea Old Church, overlooking... What's the name of that bridge again?
That one I don't know. I don't remember.
Right, because... Oh, there are so many bridges around here. And... and we are overlooking the Thames. And there's that statue.
I don't remember the name of it.
No. But we are right at one of the corners of Chelsea.
Yes.
So we are closer to the statue now, and the statue is apparently depicting Chelsea Embankment, which opened 1874.
It's actually a lampstand.
So yes, it is. Did you find a name for this statue?
It doesn't say.
No. Right. And over here is Albert Bridge. Wasn't that one? Albert Bridge? And let's see. And those statue over here is Sir Thomas More. Wasn't he one of the early socialists?
Oh, yes.
He was the one who wrote Utopia?
Utopia.
Yes. Which means the land that doesn't exist.
Yes, but he was rather a proto-socialist.
Yes, I guess you could call him that.
Yes, because socialism didn't exist.
Yes, but I guess he was right about that part.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Utopia.
Yeah, and Utopia means a place that doesn't exist.
Yes.
Yes, they should have stayed with that.
Yes, they should. But they didn't. No.
So here is a better picture of the statue of Sir Thomas More. And he lived from 1478 till 1535. I think he was in some pretty nasty conflict with King Henry VIII, and I don't think it ended well for him. So Mr. Kintington,
yes.
Where are we now?
We are Buckingham Road.
Yes, so Buckingham is over there somewhere, right in front of us.
Yes.
So let's go there then.
Yes, we are going to visit the Queen.
Yes, let's see if she'll accept us as her guests.
Oh, she does. Oh, we'll... already. We have a chat. We had a chat this morning.
Right. Okay. We'll see.
Yes.
So this is the front of Buckingham Palace.
Yes, the east front.
Yes, the east front.
The most famous.
Right, the one we have seen on TV.
Yes.
And since it's a British flag and not the royal flag.
Yes, the Union flag.
Right. This means the Queen is not gone?
Well, that's a complicated question because this is the Queen's official, in some sense.
Yes, she's not here.
Her official London residence. But it's not her de jure.
Right.
That is St. James' Palace.
Yes, which is not very far away.
No, but this is where she lives and sleeps also.
Yes, and she's not here.
No.
So we won't be having any tea with the Queen?
Oh, yes, we are. We are going back there later.
Oh, we'll see about that.
Yes, it seems to be some kind of Commonwealth meeting. If you look at those flags.
Right, one moment. Okay. So there are a bunch of flags over there?
Yes, and you see the first flag on the left, that's the Commonwealth flag. And the other flags are the nation flags of the Commonwealth nations.
Right.
Yes.
So the blue one with the yellow...
that's the Commonwealth flag.
Right, and then we have...
The flag of the Empire, I would like to say.
Yes, yes, although the Empire isn't there anymore.
Oh, I don't understand what you're saying. And the other flags are the flags of the Commonwealth nations.
Yes, we have the Union Jack.
Yes.
And the Canadian Maple Leaf.
Yes, and Jamaica, you could perhaps see Jamaican flag.
Yeah, it's behind there.
Yes.
Yeah, you're right.
Yes.
Jeffrey!
So they're having some kind of meeting then. About this here? Yes. Yes. Okay. Now I need something.
After leaving Chelsea, I have also learned that some interesting people live there. The Irish-born football player George Best lived in Chelsea. His name was on the wall at the Pig's Ear, where I had a late breakfast one day. Reggae artist Bob Marley lived in Oakley Street in Chelsea in the late 1970s, escaping violence in Jamaica after an attempt against his life. And both Oscar Wilde and his brother Willie Wilde lived in Chelsea. All in all, Chelsea is a nice part of London. London have many interesting and beautiful places, so let's keep London a Western metropolitan. Would you? If you like what I do, if you think what I do is important, please consider sending me a dollar, or pound, or two, or 10, or 100. That's always greatly appreciated. Also, check out Assyrian King on Islam in the video I uploaded right before this one. And remember that I live stream tomorrow, Saturday, at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 2 p.m. Mountain Time, 3 p.m. Central Time, 4 p.m. Eastern Time, 9 p.m. Western European Time, 10 p.m. Central European Time, 11 p.m. Eastern European Time, and midnight, further Eastern European Time. So, until next time, have a nice day, God bless, and God save the United Kingdom.